A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 7th March, on the front page you have, as part of RBI bailout, SBI to pick up 49% in Yes Bank. So RBI has announced a draft reconstruction scheme for the beleaguered Yes Bank, aimed at protecting depositors' funds, and it has brought in SBI as an investor. It will pick up 49% in Yes Bank. So it will protect jobs for a year or two, and a 6-member board has been set up for the bank. So according to the draft plan, authorized capital for the restructured bank will be 5,000 crores with 2,500 crore equity shares of rupees 2 each, aggregating to 4,800 crores. So this is there. SBI had said its board was exploring investment in Yes Bank, and now it has announced it will pick up 49% stake. Then next is, Supreme Court upholds 2018 order on land acquisition. So, Constitution Bench of the Supreme Court has held that land acquisition proceedings under 1894 Act will not be deemed to have lapsed under Section 24(2) of the Right to Fair Compensation and Transparency of Land Acquisition, Rehabilitation and Resettlement Act of 2013 if the authorities have tendered the compensation by deposit in the treasury. So, 5-judge bench has given this ruling that landowners who had refused to accept compensation, who sought reference for higher compensation, cannot claim that the acquisition proceedings had lapsed under the 2013 Act. So, Constitution Bench has affirmed the ruling by a 3-judge bench earlier in the Indore Development Authority case. And it has overruled an earlier coordinate bench ruling in the Pune Municipal Corporation case of 2014. Then below you have, Center cannot brand organizations political. So, central government cannot brand an organization political and deprive it of its right to receive foreign funds for using legitimate forms of dissent like Band, Hartal, and Roko, Road Roko, Jail Bharo to aid a public cause. So, any organization which supports a cause of a group of citizens agitating for their rights without a political goal or objective cannot be penalized by being declared as an organization of a political nature. So, this is what the Supreme Court bench has ruled, and they cannot be deprived of foreign funds on this ground. On page 5 you have, unprecedented rain, farmers fear damage to wheat crop. So another bout of western disturbance is approaching, and one has widespread rain has damaged wheat crops here in Punjab and Haryana, and this has left farmers and experts worried as they fear the inclement weather may damage the standing crops. On page 7, you have Maharashtra government's budget. It's called Development Program 2020-21. So it has one-time settlement scheme for farmers whose debt is more than 2 lakh. Then it has an MLA development fund, which will increase from 2 crores to 3 crores. And 5 crores is set up for Transgender Rights Protection and Welfare Board. Then All Women Police Station and Office of State Women's Commission will be set up in every district. And electricity duty on industrial use has been reduced from 9.3% to 7.5% of consumption charges. Also, VAT on petrol and diesel has been increased by rupees 1 per litre. On page 8, you have, Supreme Court stays order on Kerala poll records. So, Supreme Court has stayed a Kerala High Court order directing the State Election Commission to conduct the local body elections on the basis of electoral roll it had prepared for Lok Sabha elections of 2019. So, 3-judge bench of the Supreme Court led by the CJI has frozen the Kerala High Court order for a fortnight. So, High Court had also directed the State Election Commission to update the list incorporating names of qualified voters up to February 7, 2020 for the civic body polls expected to be held in November 2020. So, Supreme Court has stayed this Kerala High Court order. On page 9, you have again regarding coronavirus scare. And here you have, delimitation panel for Jammu and Kashmir northeastern states set up. So Law Minister on Friday has issued an order to set up delimitation commission for the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and the northeastern states of Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur and Nagaland. So we have discussed earlier too, a delimitation commission actually determines the territorial constituency for the purpose of elections. So readjusting the division of each state into these constituencies happens according to the census data. It means each constituency should approximately represent the same population. So this exercise has to be done at regular intervals over the years. So that is there. So this has been done for the Union Territory. Delimitation Commission in India is a powerful body whose orders have the force of law and cannot be called in question before any court. So Jammu and Kashmir is newly formed Union Territory, and in the northeastern states it was not done earlier because delimitation as such for all state legislative assemblies has been completed, Lok Sabha and state legislative assemblies, in November 26, 2008, according to 2001 census. For these states it has not been done because there was fear in the northeastern states, threat to that this exercise would result in threat to peace and public order. On the editorial page, the first editorial is banking on bailouts. So this is regarding the front page news, Yes Bank bailout. So the prompt bailout proposal for Yes Bank, while commendable, raises several questions. That if any bank goes in trouble, RBI would protect it. Then banks don't have to worry about anything. So this is there. So it says that the fact that the lender, that is Yes Bank, ended up at the resolution state without ever being placed under central bank's prompt corrective action framework also raises question mark over how and why Yes Bank eluded the specifically tailor-made solution to address weakness of banks. And here you have double-edged sword. So this is regarding Supreme Court ruling giving relief to cryptocurrency exchanges. So though the relief has been given, but still the need to regulate them cannot be denied. So that issue is covered here. And the lead article is making the environment conducive for justice. So this is regarding dire situations, how they require urgent action, proactive intervention by the judiciary that can prevent a slide into chaos. The judiciary had responded, we had seen, saying that they cannot stop the riots. The CJI had made a statement in the while hearing the case. So this is there. And below you have monetary policy can't combat the COVID-19 impact. So the impact of new coronavirus will be there on the economy, and a rate cut can help boost sentiments, but that will be transient because market's reaction after federal rate cut means US banks rate cut proves after that, you know, a rate cut here can boost sentiments, but it will not be able to combat the impact. Then on Saturdays on op-ed page, you have ground zero coverage. So this is when the center cannot hold. So this is regarding the worst communal violence in recent times, when mobs went on rampage in Northeast Delhi for 2 days, killing 53 people and destroying homes, schools and shops. So report on the communal fault lines, the state apathy and hope that lingers amidst despair is covered here. So here you can see this is a mosque in Shiv Vihar. On page 12, you have India joins Indian Ocean Commission as observer. So India has been approved as observer state for 5-nation grouping in the Western Indian Ocean, which includes Madagascar, Comoros, Seychelles, Mauritius and French Reunion. So members of the Indian Ocean Commission have decided on India's application at a meeting last week. So the decision is that India will join China, which has been made an observer in 2016, as well as International Organization for Francophonie, which is a 54-nation French-speaking collective, the European Union, Malta, they were all observers admitted in 2017, and now India has been admitted as an observer in the Indian Ocean Commission. Then, two bills have been passed, you can see Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code Amendment Bill and Mines and Minerals Amendment Bill by the Lok Sabha. Then here you have TDD clarifies on withdrawal of 1,300 crores from Yes Bank. So, authorities of Tirumala Tirupati Devastham said that withdrawal of 1,300 crores from the crisis at Yes Bank late in 2019 had nothing to do with the present crisis. The TDD said that the money was withdrawn in October 2019 and this was on maturity of deposit. You can see TDD cash deposits in the bank crossed 12,000 crores in April 2019. So, this is there. So, board recently projected 706 crore income from the interest on deposits for 2020. So, now the Tirumala Tirupati Devastham's board, they said they have taken a decision that they will deposit money only in nationalized banks. So they have removed the money from Yes Bank and deposited in nationalized banks. on international page again, new coronavirus related news in Iran, and this is regarding attack in Afghanistan. 27 dead in this attack, and Islamic State has claimed responsibility for this. So earlier we had seen Taliban attacks, and now Islamic State has claimed responsibility for this attack. And this is World Health Organization, which says make containment highest priority. So all countries should make containing the outbreak of coronavirus their top priority. So pointed out at Iran's national action plan to combat one of the world's worst outbreaks after a slow start. And this is regarding Syria ceasefire. So in Syria, new ceasefire has been brokered by Russia and Turkey, but in northwest Syria. But after years of failed truces, residents are not happy. They are still cynical. And this is Pakistan against any security role for India in Afghanistan. So Pakistan foreign minister has said that Pakistan does not want any security role for India in Afghanistan, as he accused India of playing the role of a spoiler in the war-torn country of Afghanistan. So it says India has been a key stakeholder in Afghanistan. It has already spent $2 billion in reconstruction of Afghanistan, but in the peace talks, US does not want India. But then India is keen on playing a key role, and US has supported India. So we'll see how further developments take place in Afghanistan. On business page, you have 30 days is outer limit for Yes Bank resolution. So this is RBI Governor Shaktikant Das, who has said that decision on bank has been taken to maintain stability of banking sector, and this outer limit of 30 days has been announced. He said, when we found that we cannot wait and should not wait any longer, we decided to intervene. So, but then as the editorial also pointed out, without any background, without any action taken under prompt corrective action or any such steps being taken, Yes Bank has been bailed out. Then this is saying yes to troubled borrowers caused lender due. So rapid growth and governance issues led to the decline of Yes Bank. So this is the entire timeline of this crisis being detailed out here. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.